Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Just to let you know, we'll be starting our award ceremony in 5 minutes' time. So just a quick 5 minute warning. If you'd like to take your seats, we'll be starting in 5 minutes. Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Enginuity for our seventh year, but our sixth annual Dyslexia Awards and Celebration evening. It's open to the entire UK for all our awards for the first time in 2022, and for the very first time, it has been live streamed. So hello to everybody that's currently watching from home and enjoying our award ceremony online. And of course, the highlights of this evening will be available on the Dyslexia Awards YouTube channel as well. So we are here to celebrate the achievements of dyslexics across the United Kingdom and those employers and educators who empower, encourage and utilise their dyslexic employees and students. Just a few housekeeping notes. The fire exits are located at both sides of the building. We're not expecting a fire alarm, so if the alarm does sound, you'll be ushered by the stewards to form at the congregation point in the car park. The toilets are situated through the door halfway down on the right-hand side between the seated area and the bar, and you can make your way onto the far side of Enginuity if you need the bathroom. There is a cash and card pay-as-you-go bar at the back of the room. Please feel free to purchase your drinks through the evening, and you will find complimentary water on your table. And a big thank you to Wenlock Water for those, and Tanners for the welcoming drinks that they supplied to the event. Please ensure your mobile phones are set on silent. We do encourage you to use your mobiles for social media posts during the event, so please feel free to tweet, use Facebook or Instagram or any of your social media platforms through the proceedings this evening using @DyslexiaAwards and the hashtag DyslexiaAwards2022, which you can see on most of the screens through the evening should you need to, and they're also printed on the programmes that you'll find on your table. We have good news and bad news. The good news is there is guest Wi-Fi and the login information is in your programme. We are, however, told that there's an area in the middle of the room that's a bit of a black spot. So if you try and get on and you can't, it's just about where you're sitting. So you might want to sort of sidle over to another side of the room. But there is Wi-Fi available in the majority of the room. We also have our programme being streamed. So a big thank you to Stage and Studio Services, who are providing our live streaming tonight for everyone at home. And you may well be caught on camera because we have got video cameras looking out at you as well as in my direction. And of course, our photos are being taken as well. So if there's anybody that doesn't wish to have the photograph taken, if you make yourself known to our photographers. Our charity in focus this year is the Firefighters Charity. We'll be playing Heads and Tails a little bit later on. And people watching at home, you can log on to the website and make donations if you wish to support the charity and the event that's going on. Guests, you will find an envelope on the middle of your table that looks like that. Now, if you want to play Heads and Tails when we do it a little bit later on, you're encouraged to make a donation to put some pennies or even some paper notes into the envelope, and then you'll be welcome to play Heads and Tails. There is a prize of £50 for our winner on Heads and Tails, and all the proceeds of the competition that we're doing a little later on will go to the Firefighters Charity, which is the event's chosen charity this year. So you need to put your money in those envelopes at a suitable time. Now, what I'd like to do is welcome onto the stage Ellie, who's going to say a few words to kick things off. Give her a round of applause.
I have a scrappy piece of paper, not a nice script. So, firstly, thank you for being here, everybody. Can I ask our finalists to stand up, please? Oh, do you know what? I'm very sorry. Can I scratch that? Can I please ask... Texas, I'm so sorry. Can I please ask our finalists to put their hands up in the air like this? And can I ask you just to give everybody a wave? Thank you. OK, if that's the worst the evening gets, I think we're doing all right. So, just thank you for being here, and thank you to all the dyslexics in the room for... being part of the Dyslexia Awards story. My aim is to turn the negative publicity of dyslexia on its head. There's always the comments of we overcame dyslexia or we succeeded in spite of, but actually we have skills and talents, and that's what this evening is all about. Also, to the educators and the employers in the room who do a really good job and spot talent and nurture it, thank you for realising we have potential. It's very needed and very welcome. So whilst you're here, I would like you to think about being finalists in the light of a bit of a channel your inner actor. So personally, I've been at nomination stage, shortlist stage, finalist stage, winning stage, each time not always winning. And what I've learned on all those things is it's, somebody said earlier, it's the taking part that counts, and it really is. So being in this room with amazing people, talk to people, talk to the other people in your category, talk to people in different categories, and talk to them about dyslexia, your story, your journey, and the positives that there are. So channel your inner Oscar-nominated actor. You never see an Oscar-nominated actor who hasn't won an Oscar shy away from the fact that they were Oscar-nominated. In fact, I think you probably hear more about the Oscar-nominators, or nominated, than you do the winners. I would like you to do that for the Dyslexia Awards and to champion dyslexics. Use this platform. It's not a major platform. We're just a little awards. But use it to shine a light on being dyslexic and positive and showing the world that we are amazing. And be proud. So talk to people, relax, enjoy, and remember, if you're here or here on the list, it's because you're amazing. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ellie. And isn't it great to be back with people in the same room? As much as I love talking to you through a video camera, it is lovely to see happy smiling faces back in Enginuity for the event. I'd now like to welcome Councillor Raj Mehta to the stage to say a few words and officially open our awards evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Councillor Raj Mehta.
Thank you. Before, obviously, I open and say a few words, we know in the past few weeks we've lost Our Majesty the Queen, and I just wanted to have a few minutes silence before I start. Thank you. Okay, thank you, and obviously welcome everyone this evening. Thank you to Ellie for the invitation, and congratulations to everyone that's in the room, whether you're a finalist, you're all winners at the end of the day. I enjoy coming to this event. I remember I was here a few years ago, just before lockdown, and I disclosed something that evening, and I'll disclose it again. I'm dyslexic myself as well, and it's a big thing to open up and say. But I think Ellie's encouragement and vision made me disclose it openly. So thank you, Ellie. Before I open the event, I just want to say, if everyone could give a bigger round of applause, a big round of applause for Ellie on the work she does, please. The work Ellie's done in the community has made us proud, and being the mayor of the borough, I'm so proud, and the honour you received was well deserved, Ellie. You know, it was long waited, but it was well deserved, so well done to that. This evening, do enjoy yourself and do participate, and as Ellie said, let's mingle together. We're all one big family, one big community. And on behalf of the leader of the council and his cabinet, well done again, and enjoy the evening, and officially open the event this evening. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Councillor Raj Mehta. Having watched Raj do something I did about an hour and a half ago, I'm going to tell you all that here, the floor is not level, right? So when you get to here, there's a ramp that goes up, and if your feet don't go up, you do that, and those people at home get a right old giggle because there's a camera right there. So just so you know, when you get to about here, it's time to start marching and picking your feet up as you go. Yeah. So do be mindful that if you're making your way up, that there's a little sort of trap for you there. And the hope is that if enough of you trip, we'll be able to have a holiday in Barbados with the £250 from You've Been Framed. So, ladies and gentlemen, tonight has been made possible by financial contributions from our steadfast and amazing award sponsors. They include service providers and our table gift suppliers and information on our programmes and tables. Please take the programmes home with you. There are enough for each of our finalists and some for guests as well. There's also a wooden butterfly for a keepsake on the table for every guest here this evening. And there are some balloons, which you can see beautifully on the table. Now, I know that balloons can often be something that people like to take home. And I have it on good authority from Christine, who sponsored the balloons, that if you'd like to take a bunch home with you this evening, then you're more than welcome to do so. However, what she has said, it would be lovely if you add some additional pounds or notes into the charity envelope if you intend on taking balloons home with you, just as it would support the charity of the evening. But you are welcome to take them home with you, and donations would be gratefully received. Table gifts are a great way to promote local businesses and also to act as an icebreaker. So thank you to the local businesses this year. We've got various different gifts for our guests, and you can share on social media chatting about the different gifts that you've had on your table and use the hashtag Dyslexia Awards when you're posting about your table gifts, so that the posts can be shared by the organisers of the event, and of course we can raise some publicity from the companies that have sponsored and make those gift bags possible. Before we get on to our main course, we would like to invite the following people onto the stage area for a photo. Please remember, less than a minute ago I told you about the floor, right? So there is no excuses now for catapulting yourself into my arms when you get to that ramp. So we would like to invite the following finalists to come to the stage area for a group picture. They are Mike Jones, Rosie Stone, Simon Washbrook, Clive Knowles, Matt White, Natalie Petrzyk, Denise McGowan's representative, Kathy Baker, Finn MacArthur, Morgan Jones, Texas Bishop, Rebecca Nuttall, Northumbria Police Representative, Shropshire Fire and Rescue Representative, Katie Firmston, Andrew Tabakat, Samantha Jones, Tina Biring, and if they could make their way onto our stage area for a group photograph prior to the start, as I would like you all to give them a bit of a round of applause as well, because they are indeed our finalists.
Be ashamed of all my scars. Run away. a drama mind. This is brave, this is brutal.
Brilliant, ladies and gentlemen, please give our finalists a big round of applause. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And now, what I would like to do is just give a mention to our finalists that are watching at home and can't be with us today. There is a camera next to me that can see your rapturous applause. So a big thank you as well, if you're watching at home at the moment, to finalists including Andy Willis, Emma Lockett, and Jacob Diaz Pablo. Ladies and gentlemen, give a round of applause. Also, there are two finalists who wish to remain nameless. I'll tell you more a little bit why that is a little bit later on in our proceedings. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you our 2022 Dyslexia Awards finalists. So now we kick off our 2022 Dyslexia Awards sponsors. A big thank you to these. Without these companies, this event here tonight would not be possible. Global Freight Services Limited, Darwin Wealth Management, Exclusive Solutions Limited, CGR Business Solutions, the Federation of Small Businesses, In the Loop, Valkay Web Design, Scanning Pens Limited, and Reclaim Tax UK. Can we give those a round of applause for making tonight possible? Before we serve you dinner, and we know that you've come here for the food, two Community Shining Star Awards will be presented this year. We have two categories, age 13 to 19 and age 20 plus. The award nominees are clearly all people who are inspirational, supportive, encouraging, have great community spirit and commitment, dedicated to helping others, the kind of person who makes people smile. The first award is the Community Shining Star for age 13 to 19. It's been sponsored by Global Freight Services Limited, and Anton Gunter will present our award shortly. All three finalists for this category are dedicated to making a difference in their community, where they live, or the wider community of dyslexics. Their nomination clearly shows how well they are thought of and respected in their communities, and how they are advocates for supporting others, shining stars, and volunteering and ventures. Our finalists are Finn MacArthur, Jacob Diaz-Polo, and Morgan Jones. Our judges all agreed that the three finalists are clearly having a positive impact on their community, and they are truly deserving of their nominations and have been here this evening as finalists. But the winner had to be chosen, and eventually our judges agreed unanimously on the 2022 winner. Our winner is an individual who dedicated a lot of time to their local community, volunteering for local Cubs and Scouts, taking part in fundraising activities like backpacking, sponsored walks, collecting for their local food bank, volunteering for the Scouts and Cubs, inspiring youngsters to achieve, and they are referred to as trustworthy, empowering, nurturing, caring, and inspiring. So I'd like to invite Anton up to announce the winner. So Anton, you better open the envelope and let us know who's the winner.
Before we do that,
this
year, with every awards dinner that we've sponsored, we've done an award selfie, okay? So I'm sorry, Ellie, I know you glared at me when I said I was going to do it, but we're going to do it. So I'm not going to tell everyone to stand, but just do whatever you feel like you want to do.
Here we go. We're in it. Okay, here we go.
Wave.
Excellent work.
Then my second part of tonight, isn't it amazing to have an MBE in the room? Come on, let's give it up for her. But finally, now that the suspense has built, the winner, sponsored by Global Freight Services. Is Morgan Jones.
Well done, ladies and gentlemen. Big round of applause for our first winner. The Community Shining Star Award 20 Plus Award is sponsored by Darwin Wealth Management. Unfortunately, Darwin are unable to make it to the awards tonight, so I'll be representing them. This award, again, is for three outstanding finalists: Andy Willis, Rebecca Nuttall, Texas Bishop. As the name suggests, the award is about community giving back or investing in the community. All three of these finalists contribute to their community, and without exception, they are outstanding, bringing people together, inspiring others, and showing that dyslexia is nothing to be ashamed of. Shining examples of a shining star, absolutely. All three empower others to achieve. However, there can only be one winner. Our judges said the winners were clearly held in the highest regard by their communities. Their nominators were so impressed at the personal dedication, the care, the determination, and the work at a charity shop twice a week, helping to run a variety of youth clubs, including setting up a special needs youth club, supporting Ukrainian refugees, and they assist in teaching music, to name just a few things. So, envelope time. Our Shining Star Award, sponsored by Darwin Wealth Management. The winner is Texas Bishop. Well done, Texas, and there's some very nifty manoeuvring. I don't think I could have got anywhere near that. Well done. So, just to let you know, if you have dietary requirements, you don't need to worry. Your food will be brought to you on your tables, and that affects tables numbers 1 and 3. If you're at home at the moment and you're watching our live stream, we're about to feed our guests, so feel free to grab a little bite to eat yourself. We'll be back in just over 45 minutes with our next set of awards as we reconvene with our presentation. We'll put a rundown on the screen 10 minutes before we return, but we're taking a break to have some food. And ladies and gentlemen, your food is about to be served. Don't forget, get to know people on your table, have a mingle and a chat with the various different groups and organisations that are on your table, and it won't be long till your food is served. Thank you very much.
And that'll be the two spare seats then. So, oh, don't worry.
Thank you. She does that.
Ladies and gentlemen, just to let you know, in around 5 minutes' time, we'll continue with our award celebration. So in around 5 minutes' time, once the table's been cleared, we will continue with our award celebration. Thank you. and gentlemen, we hope you enjoyed your meal and welcome back for our presentation of awards. Just to let you know, the two education awards finalists have been asked for their names not to be made public. Now, this does create a real challenge for an event like this one. Once judges have made their agreed decision, regardless of what the nominees decide, they never change their minds or alter the decision. So once the award has been presented by the judging panel, regardless of what the finalists decide, the winner always stays the same. If finalists cannot make it to the awards, they are still winners. We do find a way to present them their award, whether it be later on or in private, because we are very proud of what they have achieved and the awareness that they've raised. Now, most of us in this room know how vitally important and pivotal good educational professionals are. Teachers, teaching assistants, and special educational needs coordinators, SENCO, they have the ability to positively impact and shape the future of students that they work with. They genuinely believe in you and your abilities and instills a real self-belief that sticks with you for your entire life. That's why Ellie is really adamant that she wants to keep the educational award as part of the dyslexia celebrations for every year, and we need your help encouraging people to go for this award. We need you to reach out to more educators and help getting them nominated for these awards in the coming years. It's really important that those who do a great job be recognised and celebrated, as it sends such a good message to other people on how a positive impact makes a real difference on people's lives, particularly those with dyslexia. So spread the word and encourage other people to nominate. So we move on to that very award, the Educational Award, created especially to recognise and celebrate those amazing educational professionals out there that do great work. Those educational professionals who make a real difference in our lives. Many of us in the room will have been lucky enough to have an experienced, really great teacher. You know, those ones whose voice you can still hear telling you that you can. And those that are the kind of people at these awards are for. But the problem is with the kind of educator that doesn't realise how amazing a job that they do, and therefore they don't necessarily think they're doing something worthy of an award. These awards have noticeably been the hardest to get people to accept their nominations for. So many nominees don't want to continue in the process of the awards, pulling out just before or withdrawing completely, and they decide they don't want their names publicised. Our first education award is for learning support, sponsored by Sally Joyner from In The Loop. This award is open to the learning support professionals who work with dyslexic students to make a positive difference across the UK. They should have the ability to read learners they work with, making learning fun, enjoyable and relevant. And their passion for enjoyment for what they do shines through. The kind of professional that makes a real difference in their students' education and usually their lives. Often having a positive, long-lasting you can do impacts upon students that travel with this into their adulthood and that self-belief that makes them successful in what they go on to do in later life. As you can see on the screen, we have two finalists that don't want to be publicly recognised. So we can name Tina Biring, and we have observed the other nominees' wish to stay anonymous. Our judges unanimously agreed and were really impressed with our winner. She clearly is very active in the support that she offers students, colleagues, and the college. She shows an empathetic understanding of dyslexia that helps her students progress and succeed. In fact, so impressed with her, they also put her into the recommended section for the Excellent Educator Award as well. So I'd like to invite Sally from In The Loop to come up and announce the winner of this category. Sally.
And the winner is, for the Learning Support Award, Tina Biring. I can see.
ladies and gentlemen, our winner. The next award is the Excellent Educator Award, sponsored by VK Web Design. Rob Udakis will be presenting our award, and the category is open for nominations of exceptional educators. Could be teachers, trainers or tutors who work with dyslexic students in the UK. Nominees must have a positive, productive and inclusive attitude. Be dyslexic aware and dyslexia friendly. Be encouraged and inspirational. Our finalists are Andrew Tabakat, Katie Firmiston, and Tina Biring. Our judges were impressed with all of the nominees for this category and unanimously agreed on their winner and the three finalists. They would like to thank all of the nominees and the finalists for their dedication to education. Our judges said about the winner, they were particularly impressed that the individual worked extremely hard to make sure their students get the help and support they need to succeed. They were also impressed at the impact that they had on their colleagues and understanding the proportion of inclusion. Rob, if you'd like to come up onto the stage and announce the winner, please.
And the winner is Katie Firmiston.
And the next award is the Special Educational Coordinator, the Senko Award, sponsored by Scanning Pens. Open to Senkos who have a positive, proactive and inclusive attitude. Be dyslexia aware and dyslexia friendly. Actively promote dyslexia awareness and inclusion. Go above and beyond their call of duty. Lead by example, practicing and promoting inclusivity, inspiring staff, students and parents. They motivate and empower students and staff. Two of our finalists have withdrawn from the process, and our third finalist is Samantha Jones. Now, the winner works extremely hard to make sure that her students get the help and support they need to succeed, and that her colleagues understand what they need to do to promote inclusion. And she clearly has an excellent work ethic and dedication to her work, frequently going above and beyond her role to ensure students get what they need and what they're entitled to. So I'm going to open the envelope on behalf of Scanning Pens.
And we'll find out who our winner is. So the winner for the Special Educational Coordinator role is Samantha Jones.
And thank you to Scanning Pens for the sponsorship of that award. And on those educational awards, as I mentioned previously, it is a really difficult task to acknowledge the educators, but they are the ones that make the real difference. I can remember a classroom assistant that helped me out at the age of 7, which led to my diagnosis at 9 years old. And bearing in mind, that was a while ago, it was quite revolutionary to have somebody understand and connect with you at such an early age. And it makes such a difference going forward. And I think nominating and acknowledging people within these educational categories is really important to highlight the good work that's been done so other teachers, educators and SENCOs can work off those examples. So spreading the word, shouting about what you're doing and encouraging other people to be involved in that makes a real difference. So please spread the word. Please acknowledge the teachers that do well. So you have a question? They can be anybody that works with, helps or assists a dyslexic. They don't have to be dyslexic themselves. But it is really important to highlight and acknowledge the great work that they do. And I think looking at it, for some, they feel like they're just doing their jobs and that it's not necessarily something that they should be awarded for because they're being paid. But actually, for anybody that is dyslexic and somebody offers help and support and advice, it is life-changing. And I can remember it 42 years later. So I'm sure that happens to anybody else in this room that's been a good educator. And the only way we can get this accepted and understood is by us spreading the word, sharing the people that have been nominated, the people that have won, to encourage other people and acknowledging the good practice that are done in our schools, education, youth club and different environments that enable us to thrive. So thank you for sharing those words. Michael, Ellie's dad and I have put our hands up to help you out, because we're about to serve pudding, and we appreciate that some of you are dieting, and some of you may not like extra calories. So should you have a dessert that you don't think you can manage, between Michael and I, we will assist you. We're here to help you. So just to let you know, for viewers at home, we're about to embark on dessert. So we feel that Michael and I probably need about 30 minutes to polish them all off. And then we'll be back with some more awards. Ladies and gentlemen, teas, coffees and desserts are going to be brought around to the table. And then we will continue with more of our amazing awards. Don't forget, tweet about our educational awards. Share it on social media. Encourage people to be part of these awards and acknowledge the people that make a real difference. Pudding will be served. We'll be back in 30 minutes. the desserts are coming round. Also, our team are coming round to collect the heads and tails envelopes. There is a £50 cash prize up for grabs if you want to play, but you do need to make a donation in this envelope. Whether it's coins or indeed notes, whatever you can give, everything that goes in this envelope will go to the Firefighters Charity, which is the chosen event charity tonight. So if you haven't already done so, pop a donation, and everybody that makes a donation is welcome to play Heads and Tails, the easiest game you're going to play tonight, and a £50 prize could well be yours. We'll be doing that momentarily, so make your donations. Also, if you fancy taking a selection of balloons home with you, if you want to put a little bit extra in the envelope as part of the charity donations, which entitle you to take home a bunch of balloons, then you're welcome to do that. But our team are coming around to collect the envelopes, so any donations would gratefully be received. just to let you know, ladies and gentlemen, there's a 10-minute warning for teas and coffees, and then we'll continue with our award celebrations. For people watching at home, we'll be back with you in 10 minutes' time for the next set of awards.
Thank you.
business, but first off, I need to mention the Supportive Employer Award, and the sponsor of that is CRG Business Solutions, and Chris Goff will be making our presentation in a short while. The Supportive Employer Award is about recognising and celebrating the supportive employers in the country. Employers nominated for this category should have a positive, supportive, proactive approach, a positive can-do attitude, implement reasonable adjustments when needed, be positive, adaptive in their approach to training, be dyslexic aware and friendly, encouraging and inspirational. We have found over the years that employers nominated for this award have not just met the criteria, they have exceeded it. So, the three finalists at the top of the list, because they deserve to be there. They are Northumbria Police, Shropshire Fire and Rescue Service, and Support Elite at Home. Our judges want to express how impressed they were with all three of our finalists, and that our winner this year has once again excelled the award's criteria. The judges said about the winner, as an organisation, they have welcomed dyslexics, embraced them, trained them, care for them, and have throughout a great structure, kindness and support, taking people to the next level. Staff are very grateful for the support they've received, and this has created a positive learning culture, one where they shine and excel. A massive credit to them. They should be highlighted and recognised for their hard work. They make a massive difference. So, Chris, if I could invite you up to announce the winner for me, please.
Good evening, everybody. And the winner is Northumbria Police.
Well done, and thank you very much. Our next award is Amazing Art. And this award is sponsored by Reclaim Tax UK. They cannot be with us this evening, so Ellie will present the award on their behalf. Artists nominated for our Amazing Art Award are nominated because people, their art, and they are amazing. It is about their art, not where they went to school or why they decide to use a particular style. It's about the impact of their work and how their work moves or inspires people, or indeed has the wow factor. It doesn't matter what medium the artist uses. All that matters is that our nominators think that the art and the artist are amazing. We all right? Have you had a whoopsie? Are we all right?
Yeah.
Have we saved the day? No problem. Our panel of Art Awards judges include one of our previous Dyslexic Art Award winners, Wayne. What a cracking panel this new mix is. Their decision for the top three was unanimous, and they were really impressed with all three of the finalists. They discussed the merits of each and eventually realised that they had all chosen the same winner. Our amazing art finalists are Denise McGowan, Emily Lockett, and Rossi Stone. Our judges said about the finalists, they felt humbled by our winners' achievements. They are multi-talented. They've achieved so much and they have helped so many. And they are true ambassador. So I'd like Ellie to come up and announce the winner.
Just checking, you wouldn't believe I actually did this myself. So, the winner is Rossi Stone. Haven't already checked him out, I am biased because I know Rossi and I love the stuff he does. If you haven't already checked out Deco Comics, please do and follow his story. I, by the way, had nothing to do with the decision of who won. That's down to my judges. Thank you,
Ellie.
Now it is time to play our game of heads and tails. In this envelope is £50, and it's going to one of you. Well, it is if you put some money in the envelope that we collected earlier. So, what I'd like you to do, if you put some money in our charity envelopes, I would like you to stand up, please. So, everybody that's made a donation, all wave. Okay. So the way the game works, if you made a donation, you're now in with the game. We have a coin. It has been verified. It indeed has the Queen's head on one side. And on the tassel, we have a 10 pence coin with two of the three lions on the front. So all you have to do is anticipate which way round the coin will land. If you think the coin is going to land on its head side up, you need to place two hands on the top of your head. If you think the coin is going to land tail side up, two hands, one on each buttock. So, what you need to do now is commit to heads and tails. It's up to you. But no changing your mind. The rest of the table will police. But do you think the coin will go heads or tails? Heads or tails? Make your decision now, please. Has everybody made their mind up? No change in your mind now. Final answer. Up it goes. Oh, it's spinning. Look at the tension. It won't land on the side. Blimey. We'd be here all month. If your hands are on your bottom, sit down. Head stay standing. So, if you opted for heads, you're still in the game. If you said tails, sorry to say, you're out. So now, we're flipping again. Could it be heads twice in a row? If you think it will be, two hands on your heads, please. If you think this time, surely, it's going to land tails, firmly fix your hand on your buttocks. Okay, have you made your mind up? What are you doing? The lady there changed her mind four times. What? Have you, final answer. You sure? You can't change again. All right. Everybody ready? Up it goes. If your hands are on your bottoms, stay standing. Heads, sit down. So, how many we got left? One, two, three, four, five. Right. Those of you that are left, up on the stage. Up you come. On the stage, please.
There you go. He's anywhere you like, up on the stage. Thank you very much. Good work. Any spot you like. So, one of these people is winning £50. One of these. Keep moving up if they're stuck on the ramp. You can make two lines if you like. Feel free to socialise. Just jump in the front. Go right in the middle. Come on, up you go. Right there, they've kept a gap for you. There you go. Right, so make your mind up time. Hands on your heads or hands on your buttocks. You decide, heads or tails, what's it going to be? Oh, 3 to 5. Okay, up it goes. The coin has landed on tails. Off you go and sit down, the five that opted for heads. Those remaining. It's getting very tense, isn't it? 50 quid. Cool, hard cash. So what are you going to do? Heads or tails? There's always one. Make your mind up time. There we go. So, if it's tails, we've got a winner. If it's heads, we're down to the final two. Ready? Are you watching at home? Are you loving this? This is the way to spend your Saturday night on the internet, watching people guess heads or tails, isn't it? That's the future. Here we go. It is heads. Oh, oh, the pressure. The pressure. Rick, we're going to let you choose first. Heads or tails? We need two different answers. If you both pick the same, we're going to be here all night, or you're both going to be out, which technically means I might win the money. It's up to you. Okay. No, they need to know what they've bet, because otherwise they might best the same. Okay. Right. You want to go heads or tails? Pop your hands. Exactly. You're going heads. Okay. Keep your hands on your heads. It's not a part-time game. You're committing here. You're showing that you're believing in the head. It's not a nonchalant. I mean, I appreciate there's hair gel, but come on. We've got a game to play here. Ready? Ready? Here it goes. Here's the tension right there. The winner is... heads! There you go, sir. You are our winner. Thank you very much, Rhea. Thank you very much for taking part. Oh, that was fun, wasn't it? And a big thank you to every one of you that made a donation for our charity in order to play that game. And another round of applause for our winner, please. Next up, we turn to our business awards next. We start with our Entrepreneur Award, sponsored by the Federation of Small Business. A representative from the Federation of Small Business is Hannah Williams, who will be presenting our award. The criteria for the award is simple. Nominations are open to UK dyslexics who demonstrate good entrepreneurial skills, have succeeded in their endeavours. Our judges have found that judging was not as simple as the criteria, but they collectively agreed on their top three very impressive finalists. Lots of discussion, clarification, rereading of the nominations. Our finalists are Clive Knowles, Matt White and Natalie Petrick. Our judges' comments about our winner was, they said, a true entrepreneur who has created a world-class visitor attraction to be proud of whilst looking after their family, customers, community and staff. If I could invite Hannah up to announce our winner, please.
Good evening, everyone. And the winner is Clive Knowles. Now, so I have been told that Clive isn't here this evening, so I will accept on his behalf, but I will make sure it gets to him. So congratulations to Clive.
Thank you, Hannah. Let's have a round of applause for Clive, and Hannah will take Clive's awards back to him.
Our next award is an innovation award. It's sponsored by Exclusive Solutions Limited, and Nicola Rust will be making the presentation for us shortly. The Innovation Award is about celebrating and recognising dyslexic innovators in the UK. Innovators who introduce new methods, ideas, or new products. Our finalists are Mike Jones, Rosie Stone, and Simon Washbrook. Our judges for the Innovation Award were really impressed with all of our finalists. Once again, this was an award category that took some deliberating and discussion. The judges would like to commend all of our finalists for their great, innovative creations. Our 2022 Dyslexia Award Innovation Award winner has taken an idea and made it commercially viable, overcome barriers to achieve innovation of a challenging product in a crowded market. They were also very impressed with how our winner has widened their reach using various relevant online platforms. If I could invite Nicola. It's all right, it says Nicola at the top and Rob at the bottom. Nicola, if you could come on stage and announce our winner for us, please.
And tonight, the Innovation Award winner is... Oh, I have to open it. Simon Washbrook.
You presented the award. Would you like to see from that side?
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Well done once again. So, now, it's time for me to welcome to the stage the founder of the wards. Are you good, Ellie? Being presented, oh, hang on, wait for it to get sorted. You good? Come on, Katie, up you come. So, the founder of awards and Elizabeth Norton, Ellie and Katie, are going to present on her behalf. Could Richard Norton make his way up for our special founders award?
So this, can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
This award is for a fab lady called Elizabeth Norton, who unfortunately is one of those educators who doesn't like a fuss. However, her son does realise how good she is and the things she's done, so he has agreed to come on her behalf this evening. Thank you. So a little bit about Elizabeth Norton, or Liz as we know her, many, many years ago, too many to mention, when this young lady was a youngster, Liz had set up a Telford Dyslexia workshop. Katie was her first student. And I'm going to pass over to Katie in a minute for her to say a message to Liz, who hopefully will either watch this from home or later on. But just a little bit about Liz. She was a teacher at Telford College, and she taught OCN Dyslexia Awareness. She worked with many teachers, parents, educators, lecturers, and she went on and trained specialist teachers. So the majority of specialist teachers in our county here in Shropshire will have at some point, if they're my age, have been trained by Liz. She has started a ripple effect that just has been so positive. I went on her course to find out more information about dyslexia for family. From there, she spotted my talent and said, would I like a Saturday job? And that's where I met Katie, Lisa, lots of other people, Kate, who's not here tonight. And from there, we went on and did all sorts of things, and so many people have benefited because of her. Colin, which camera are we on?
That one.
That one. Liz, thank you so much for everything you've done, and I'm going to hand over to Katie now.
I'm going to try and not get emotional. So like Ellie said, I was the original student of the dyslexia workshop where I got the pleasure of meeting Liz. And like Ellie said again, some people don't like a fuss. We were really hoping she would come today. But she made such a positive impact in life and made me realise, along with Ellie, that you can achieve whatever you want. So all these finalists here today, Liz, the Founders Award, it's been incredible to meet you all, how far you've come, everything you've put into the community. And we really wish Liz all the best, don't we?
So one thing is that Katie is the person that the Shining Star Awards are written about, because she travelled through Telford Dyslexia Workshop as a first student, then became the craft teacher, and then came chair, all sorts of stuff, but this, and a teacher, yeah. And this is all down to Liz. Liz started this, so thank you. And Richard, please, sorry, standing there. Yeah, please pass on to your mum. And if we, can you, are you all right to read out what's on there, or have you...
So it's with deepest gratitude and appreciation for your vision, drive and determination that empowers and champions so many Shropshire dyslexics.
Thank you. So, Elizabeth Norton.
Keep it, because you've got space for this.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Tell us you've been
amazing. I will, don't you worry. I already have done.
So that was our Founders Award for Elizabeth Norton, who will watch this at a later date. And now, Ellie remains with me on stage, because she's got a few thank yous to do, I believe.
So, first of all, we have... Thank you. In 2020, I was lucky enough to meet two people, virtually. One of which was Joanna Gordon-York, and the other one was Nicola Moss. So Joanna, I was very lucky in 2020 and got a fully funded intern who was Joanna. And she, I interviewed seven people who were all wonderful. And when I interviewed Joanna, still got two more to interview. And I remember ringing my mum to say, I found my intern. She's amazing. Dyslexic as well, which helped. And she interviewed past winners and sponsors and just got some loads of feedback to let us know what we were doing was working. So Joanna, sorry about that, I made you all jump. Joanna, in a moment, if you'd like to come up on the stage, that would be wonderful. And then I also met Nicola Moss, introduced to me by Federation of Small Businesses, who helped out when we were doing our 2020 awards on film. Mm-hmm. She helped out with the social media, helped promote it. And both of you, thank you, because you really helped me out in 2020. So if you'd like to come up to the stage, please.
So Joanna and Nicola, please make your way on the stage. Thank you very much. Picture time. So, there's a few group shots that we'd like for our little album of archive of this evening's events. So could I ask Lorna McCain, Katie and Claire to make their way up onto the stage to have a group photo, please? Lorna, Katie and Claire. Make your way, yeah.
And while you're there, bring your own gifts with you.
Katie and Claire, these two lovely ladies here, come on up, are responsible for setting up your tables today, making it look very pretty and lovely, and having the vision that I don't. They're also going to be amazing at doing all the things that we've got planned for next year. But I actually couldn't do it without them. They are amazing and take so much stress off me. So, Katie and Claire, thank you very much. Also, Lorna McCann works for Be Bold Media. I was exceptionally lucky this year to get a growth recovery grant from Telford and Wrekin Council, which has meant we were able to overhaul the website, but also engage Be Bold Media, who I think have put more into than the grant, actually. So, Lorna, thank you for everything you do. Press releases that she gets the gist of and understands that we don't suffer from dyslexia and we don't succeed in spite of it. She gets that we're empowered and we're skilled and talented. So these wonderful people, thank you very much. Round of applause.
Sorry.
I've got a thing on. Thank you. Mum, Dad, Christine and Lisa, I'll thank you all later on for everything you've done. It's too much to mention.
You want these part of these photographs? So these. Yeah. Okay, so for photographs, could we have all of our winners that are here today to make your way up for a group photograph with Ellie, please? So that's everybody. If you've also got your plaques with you, if you could bring those up with you and have a group shot with Ellie on the stage, that would be appreciated. So all our winners, and Ellie, please make your way up on the stage. It's picture time. Nine.
Gonna drown in mine.
Yes, so for our next photo, could we have, let's have a look, Simon Washbrook and Tina Birring. Could you make your way up for a photograph? Thank you very much. Brilliant, there you go, that's good. And if we could have Samantha and Morgan Jones for a photograph, please. Thank you very much. So, Samantha and Morgan, if you could make your way up to the stage for a photograph, please.
Whack a bit of background on. Whack a bit of music on.
Richard. Come on, Richard. Richard Thornton. Where are you? Come on, Rich. With your mum's trophy. Come on. Up you go. And now all that remains for us to do this evening is to welcome back on stage Ellie for her closing address.
Oh, yes.
I'll give you that. We better announce how much we have raised with your heads and tails. If Simon Hardiman from Shropshire Fire and Rescue Service would make his way on stage to collect our cheque from our fundraising game of Heads and Tails. On behalf of the Firefighters Charity. I can reveal that your generosity today has resulted in a donation to the Firefighters Charity of £503.71. We're going to keep them there till it feels really awkward. Thank you very much.
Yeah. So I indulged myself a little this year and chose a charity that I was close to my heart. I work with two fire services and I've seen the work that the Firefighters Charity does. We weren't going to have a charity in focus this year because we were going to set up as a charity ourselves, but we've had a few things get in the way, positive things, which have kept us very busy. So next year we will be a charity and the Firefighters Charity is the last one we'll have because then we'll be raising money to run the Dyslexia Awards. Again, we won't be about making loads of money. It will just be about covering costs so that I don't have to, which would be lovely. So thank you for digging deep for the Firefighters Charity. They do great stuff. And I know some of the firefighters I work with have tapped into their resources for mental health and all sorts of different things. So if you at home can donate as well, that would be great. And if you get a chance to donate in the future, please do. Shameless plug for the Firefighters Charity. Thank you very much.
That's it. You're done.
Can I have a piece of card?
Oh, yes. That one.
No, yeah.
So, as organised as a dyslexic is, too busy doing everything else, I actually forgot to write my opening speech and my last speech, which I would like to say wasn't common, but I think it happened last time as well. So, forgive me for the scrappy piece of paper. Wrong piece of paper. Christine, could you pass me the
piece? Another piece? Yeah, I don't think I've got any more, have I? Oh, hang on.
Oh, and if any of our winners would like to take their golden envelope home with them, please let us know. If you haven't got it, we'll find it for you.
I've got some up here, actually. Yeah.
So, all the finalists in the room, thank you for being here, taking part in this, and take your finalist certificates, put them in the loo, on a wall somewhere where you can see them, but somewhere you can see them every day to remind yourself how amazing you are. Please take a photo of it and hashtag us in social media as to where it is in your house or why you like looking at it or what it means to you. And the winner's trophies, if you can also take a picture of those and tag them in, that would be amazing, because the more that you do that and the more it gets out there, the more people suddenly go, oh, okay, so it's okay to be dyslexic then, it's something to be proud of. And that is what this is all about. I've seen so many amazing dyslexics with the work I do. I get to work with some great people, and they hide their light under a bushel, I think the saying is. Too ashamed, possibly going through school where most of us aren't taught the way we learn. So those educators that are good, thank you, because you deserve to be recognised. You make a difference, as Paul said earlier. It really does make a difference. So to all of you here, everybody in this room, thank you for being part of the Dyslexia Awards story and history. It's really important. This is our seventh year, but our sixth awards, and it isn't possible at all, and I know you hear this at all awards, but it really isn't possible without the support in the room from my family, the sponsors, the supporters, our amazing service providers, these three over here, the caterers, the venue, everybody that gets what we're about and why we're doing what we do, so thank you. I've had a couple of sponsors come up to me tonight already, and they're in for next year, so thank you very much. Yes. And really, just be proud. Shout loud, be proud, and celebrate your skills and your strengths. You all will have that yes moment in your life. So take a minute now and think about a moment in your life when you have gone, can you all remember that? Show of hands if you can think of a yes moment.
When there was two puddings.
That is what you need to celebrate. And for the educators out there, thank you. And if you get nominated for an award, please go ahead with it, because it gets really tiring trying to get you to come and do these things, but you're really important. Supportive employers, thank you for everything you do. I hope the supportive employers in the room will communicate with each other, take each other's emails, because you do amazing things. And just again, all the finalists. My favourite picture of the evening is all of the finalists on the stage at the beginning. That's the one that, if I did PR, would go out everywhere. So thank you very much. And can I have a round of applause again for our amazing finalists and our winners?
Thank you very much, Ellie. Thank you very much to you for coming and supporting the event, all our sponsors, all our nominees, and of course, all our winners. Thank you so much for taking the stage. We are going to leave the logo up on the stage. If you want to take selfies in front of it, you're more than welcome. As we mentioned on social media, please use the hashtag Dyslexia Awards 2022. And if, like me, sort of doing a tweet before we started, I had to copy the spelling off the programme, that's perfectly acceptable. We're dyslexic after all. So the hashtag you're using is Dyslexia Awards 2022. Thank you so much for being here, being part of this amazing celebration of some wonderful people, employers and sponsors in and around the UK. And we'll see you next year. Good night.